possession. So there's something to be understood. Right. We don't pretend to, of course, exhaust the mystery in any way, but we can show, for instance, you can't love something until you know it, right? You first know it, and then you love it. And what do you know? That's the order of processions in the Trinity, right? First, the Son proceeds from the Father, and then the Holy Spirit from the Father and the Son. So even in us, our way of knowing and loving gives us the right order in the Trinity. That we say, well, how the Holy Spirit proceeds from the Father and the Son, in the same way that love in us proceeds from a word of knowledge. You know something, and you love it, or you don't love it, right? But it proceeds from a word of knowledge. And so also, there are only two intellectual processions in us, as in God. You could say processions terminate in the procession of the will. So again, you're not going to prove, say, well, I can prove why there are only three persons in God, because there are only two processions. Why? Because there are only two processions in me, intellect and will. No, you can't prove it. But you can say, gosh, that's amazing. In us, who are made in God's image, we're knowers and lovers, we have these two mental processions, and in God, there are two processions as well. And there are only three persons on account of that. So it's not a proof, but it offers an analogy by which we can explain how it could possibly be true. So for instance, if you went to the ancient pagan philosopher Aristotle and you said, okay, well, here it goes. See, if you just suppose he was sitting right here and I just explained that and I said, so one divine essence possessed by three distinct persons. He would say, well, you know what? You need to take my philosophy of nature 101 class because that doesn't make any sense, right? He'd say, rather distinct individuals are of the same essence, are individuated by matter, right? One human nature, all of here, but many human persons. Different matter, so one, we could say one essence and many individuals distinguished by matter, not one essence and three persons, that's backwards. And so we would say, well, okay, we wouldn't have thought so either, but Christ revealed it. Okay, so we're not proving it, but what we say to Aristotle is, okay, but now that it's revealed, what I'm showing you, Mr. Aristotle, is that your reasons against don't apply. Because if we're talking about God, who's pure spirit, I'm demonstrating how it's possible for one same divine essence to have three distinct persons. Okay? By an immanent procession, a procession within God, where because it remains in God, the persons are equal, perfectly equal, co-equally the divine essence, and because there is a procession, there's a distinction. So Aristotle would, you know, immediately be convinced and be asked to be baptized. No, who knows? Okay. So Father Luke would arrange that. So, okay. But so now we come to the crowning concept that I promised to address in the title of this lecture, namely relation and subsistent relation. So a person understood as so-called a subsisting, an existing relation. So, okay, when you have one thing proceeding from another, then you have a relation between the two, right? So if you throw a stone, there's a relationship, right? There's a relationship of the stone as the one proceeding from you, and you as related to the one from whom the stone is proceeding, okay? Very simple, but you'll see how this lines up for the Trinity. So you would be related to the stone as the principle from which the stone proceeds, okay? So, and there are different kinds of relation, and I'll just name three here that St. Thomas talks about. So one is in the relation, a real relation. And here, the relation is really in the things, right? So big and small, double and half, so like two and four, or if a bulldozer's pushing dirt, so you'd have pusher and pushed, right? The relation is really in the thing, okay? The thing's either really big, or it's really, really small, or double and half, right? Two is half of four. The relation of half, it's really in the thing, the bulldozer pushing, there's something pushing in the real order. So one is a real relation. So one is real, the other is, you could say, logical only. This means only in the order of knowing. So what would be an example? The relation of identity. I'd say, well, how are you related to yourself? I mean, this is on these forms, right? You know, who are your insurance? You know, or no, you put in your information. How are you related to the person above? Self. So you'd say, well, are you related to yourself? Well, I am as myself, by identity, by as myself. Okay, but is that a real, a relation, the real order? No, it's a relation, just a logical one, one in the mind. Or you could say the relation of genus to species, right? Mental categories, so they're related. So man is a rational animal, so how is the genus related to species? Species is a subcategory, you know, a subcategory of the genus. But these are mental, I don't want to say construct, sounds artificial. So, but they're mental categories, and so those are, you could have relations. Those are relations, but they're strictly logical. And then you can have mixed relations, and here's where the things are not of the same order. So, and this is the order of knowing. So how about the idea of an apple and a real apple? Or better, maybe. That's a good word. Or God and the whole universe. So that here you have the knower and the known. Actually, that's the example I was looking for. In the knower and the known, the thing that's the knower is in the case of the idea of an apple and an apple, the idea of an apple has a real relation to the apple, right? Because it depends on it completely. But the apple doesn't care whether something has an idea of it or not, so the idea of an apple, the apple itself, the real apple, is related only logically to the idea of an apple. Because it doesn't depend on the idea at all. It's an apple here. Whether somebody has an idea of it or not doesn't change it at all, whereas the idea of that apple depends completely on it, right? You look at the apple, you get the idea of it. Okay. So I make those distinctions just because we're going to see what kind of relations are in God. So among the 10 categories that Aristotle describes beings in 10 categories, right, substance, if you study philosophy, calls it substance, and then 9 accidents, 9 properties. If you look at all the, so this is a brilliant description of the way things are and the way you can describe how things change in the world. If you look at all the 10 categories, and I'll read them to you just in a second so you can see what they are, but only, so relation is one of the categories. What are some of the others? So substance, quantity, right, so how much of there's something, relation, quality, action, passion, time, place, posture, habit. But if you looked at something, just as properties, right? Color of something, what it tastes like, how big it is, how much it weighs. If you try to take, so all these 10 categories, substance is the main one, it's what something is, so a marker, and then black is a color, so it would be give you some insight into the quality of it. If you take everything, all the categories by which you can describe a being, and Aristotle would say these 10 categories, you know, you give me anything, I'll give you these 10 categories and it will be, I'll have it sewn up. I'll have it described. If you take any one of these, you take all these 10, only in relation, only in the category of relation, do you find something that is only in our apprehension and not in reality. So I'll write that up here and you can think about that. Well, I'll give you an example. So like anything else, you know, as I said, color, taste, weight is actually in the thing, but relation deals, it can be only in the apprehension, namely it's the way it's related to something outside it. Okay, so. So only in relation do we find something. Only in relation do we find something in apprehension only. Apprehension. And the purely logical relations would be an example of that, something just in the mind. Okay, so all the other properties or accidents, in their strict and proper meaning, signify something in hearing in the subject. It's in the thing. Right? Blackness is in this tip of this marker of whiteness or how much it weighs. It's in the thing. But relation